Recording. Okay. Start letting them in.
There it is. I highlighted it.
Hey, everyone. Just be patient with me as I get everybody entered in here. I let one in and three more pop up. It's like a video game. Okay. Wow, we have good turnout today.
Scary out here.
I love that, Bill. I'm so jealous. Still letting people in. Okay, I think I have everybody. Welcome. It's so good to see all your faces. Welcome to our board meeting today. Just a few housekeeping things just to let everybody know we are recording as we do with our Zoom HOA meetings. And that is so I can post it on the portal. So in case you want to go back and listen, or maybe your neighbor is out of town and unable to come, that they can go ahead and just post, go on the portal and be able to see that. I post it under the announcement and also under the calendar. So that video will be there along with the agenda. Just some Zoom etiquette here. I'm gonna ask all of you to remain on mute, and that's just so that there's not a bunch of background noise going on so that we can all hear clearly everything that's going on. And it's totally up to you if you want to have your video on. If you don't want to be on video, you can always, if you go to the very bottom of your screen, all the way over to the left, you'll see the old-timey microphone, and you can click on that so it'll have a cross through it, and that's mute. And then on the video, there's a little, it looks like an upside down V. And if you click on that, you can choose your virtual background if you want to, like Bill has, and Ed as well. Or you can say, I don't want to be on video, and you can go ahead and make yourself not on video and just watch and listen. That's totally up to you. I'm going to go ahead and let everybody know that we are participating in the board meeting. There is a homeowner forum. And once we get to that point, if you want to type in a question in the chat, I can read that. Or if you want to unmute yourself and in an orderly fashion, raise your question, then that is appropriate. And from there, I just want to make some introductions for all of you who don't know me. I'm Dawn Wood. I am the regional HOA manager for Nova, and I manage Oak Tree. I'm there on Thursdays, so if you guys want to come down, if you have anything you need me to help you with tomorrow, I will be at Oak Tree. Also want to introduce Takara, who is our new lifestyle manager, and also Christina Peterson from Nova. She's our vice president at Nova. And I would also like to welcome Steve Bay, who is our homeowner board member, and Karen Erickson from Taylor Morrison, and Jennifer Mahaffey from Taylor Morrison. So I think I've got everybody in here. If anybody else pops in, I'll just go ahead and let them in. I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to Jennifer and share my screen so that you guys can follow along with the agenda.
Thanks, Dawn. I'll let you do that.
Okay, scrolling up, guys. Here we go.
All right, so welcome to the October Oak Tree. Can you believe it's October already? Mid-October. HOA meeting. Thanks for the introductions, Dawn. For those of you who are wondering, who are new, it looks like most of you are familiar faces, actually. Karen and I work for Taylor Morrison, and we're part of your declarant board, as well as our homeowner, our elected homeowner, Stephen Bay. So we've been working hard and got a lot of stuff going for you. So we'll just get started on the meeting. And we do ask, like Dawn said, I just wanted to reiterate, please use the chat function. Technically, the way board meetings work, if we were in person, you would be able to be, all meetings are open, so anyone can attend a board meeting. But we do ask that homeowners refrain from interjecting throughout the meeting. Sit, write down your questions or put them in the chat, and then we'll do them all in the homeowner forum. So usually the floor is closed for comments, just open for business for the board members. So we're getting formal on you. All right, we're going to call the meeting to order today at, where's my clock? Let's see, 4:07. And then the board was, Dawn emailed earlier this week our last meeting minutes, which happened to be from July of earlier this year. So Karen and Steve, you've had a chance to review those. All right, I make a motion to approve them.
Second that motion.
Yep, there you go. Thanks. All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Easy peasy. All right. So that takes us, we'll hop down to the treasurer's report. Dawn, do you have that little snippet there? And for homeowners that maybe you are not aware, all your meeting minutes reside on the portal. So if you're ever wondering, you can go back there and reference what she just scrolled past. They're always on the portal. I usually do them very soon after the meeting. So they should be up there pretty quickly.
Under documents and board meeting documents.
Perfect.
So for the financial for September 2021, the financial reports were emailed to the board on October the 14th, 2021. As of September 30th, the current account balances are total operating account assets, $909,109.26. The checking account is $908,157.70. And delinquencies as of September 30th were zero. Yay.
Nice. Great. That's just a snapshot for us. Let's see. So then we go to our committee reports. Looks like our ACC committee is up first. I know I saw Lorraine, our new ACC committee chair. So have the floor.
Hey, for those of you that aren't aware of what this ACC is or does, we are a committee that is made up of resident volunteers whose charge is to review the applications and make recommendations to the HOA board. And this process is just to ensure that architectural standards of the community are maintained throughout the whole development. And saying that, a reminder that an ACC application is required for all alterations to the outside of your home. And forms can easily be found on the HOA portal, as well as the lobby of the pavilion. And we do have one recent change when completing your forms. Now that the people can move freely around outside, residents are asked to please gather your neighbor's signatures. During the beginning of the pandemic, Dawn was gracious enough and took this on as a job that she did to ensure that the process moves smoothly. And we really appreciated that she did that. But now she needs to get back to her original job duty. So that's going to be your responsibility. The committee's been really busy processing resident requests and would like to shout out a big thank you to all the residents that prior to filling out your application, have reviewed the ACC standards, the home landscaping frequently asked questions, and the ACC pages in the Ovation Nation handbook kit, all really useful tools that a lot of hard work has been put into to try to make it easier for you to get through the process. So please use these documents. It'll make your life easier and it sure makes our life easier because the more thorough your application is, the faster it goes through and the less times we have to ask for clarifications. So thanks again. And last, the committee has noticed that residents are running into some interruptions in their projects due to either weather or supply chain delays. So if your project is being delayed, we ask that you please notify Dawn so that she can place your project on hold. And then you can contact her when you do have a confirmation restart, start, or delivery date. and also as a courtesy to your neighbors. When delays happen, if you could please notify your neighbors a week prior to the project restarting. That way they have time to do whatever they need to do so that you can get on with your project. And I think that's all it, that's it from the ACC.
Right, thanks, great. All right, so that takes us right into the Landscape Committee. I saw Ed and Craig both on here. Which one of you?
I'm afraid that's me.
Okay.
So hi everyone, I'm Ed Logan and I'm the new chairman for the Landscape Committee. The Landscape Committee, if you're not sure what it does, we monitor the landscaping maintenance done by our vendor, Monarch. We walk around to see if there's any issues that they may have missed or maybe some issues with plants, and we try to bring all those issues to Don, who will communicate them with Monarch, and we kind of take pictures, go back and make sure that corrections were done according to spec, and that our vendor is living up to the contract that we have with them. It's been a pretty busy September and October timeframe, but before I go there, I would like to say, because this is my first meeting, I would like to acknowledge our previous chairman, Craig Gable. This man has been on the committee for 2.5 years and was a great instrumental in formulating our committee and leading it down the path that it is today. So great job, Craig. We appreciate that. Some of the things that Monarch has been doing, you probably have noticed, they've been basically preparing the landscape for the coming winter months. We've been doing that by some of the, you notice they're doing some yard trimmings and plant trimmings. The plan is to have all that done and completed by around Thanksgiving so that people can put up their holiday decorations once they actually enjoy their turkeys, without worrying that Monarch's going to come along and trim your Christmas tree, so to speak. So there's also, we've got some ongoing plant replacements for those that didn't survive the summer, and they should be, that's underway, and they should be completed very, very soon if they're not already completed. We also did some unimproved area improvements there over by the preserve, leading into the preserve. We treated it, had it treated with ground cover clover, which is very inexpensive, very easy to maintain. So that looks a lot better than just the normal rock that was there. Also, you probably noticed that the irrigation system was drained just last week, or it was drained or exploded, one of the two. They turned that off and it will be coming back on in around April of 2022. Of course, we continue our weekly walks with Don. And we meet with homeowners, and we, if you have it, you see us walking around, please feel free to let us know. And lastly, we have several new homeowners that are interested in joining the Landscape Committee. And we're really interested in and looking forward to their input as well. And that pretty much wraps it up for the Landscape.
Great, thanks. All right, so Mel, I saw you on here. We'll move on to the Communications Committee.
Yeah, we communicate. If anyone doesn't know what we put out a newsletter every other month, 6 a year, and the next one will be coming out 1st of November. And I have great help with that, as along with input from just about everybody in the community at times. Miriam Hewitt takes a big load of that. Chris Sather puts up the bulletin board in the pavilion. We are going to shift to a, rather than every other month, more seasonal, since we are not doing that calendar every month. Now that Takara's here, we don't have to do that. She's going to take all that. So if you got anything to plan or put on the calendar or you want to check, she is your resource. We administer a community Facebook page, and everybody gets mad at me because I stick to the rules. We wanted to keep it a nice page, and it's more for information than your usual Facebook stuff. So you can use your other Facebook pages for that. Miriam has been instrumental in compiling a handbook, a resident handbook. We put those files on the portal. They do kind of change a lot right now because we're just getting into that, but it's a great resource to put on your computer, have at hand. You can find contact numbers for Taylor Morrison, the board, and a lot of local things that you need to know too. Plus it describes all the committees, and then there's another folder in that same folder that's in documents, handbook kit. There's one called miscellaneous helpful resources. And that just has everything we come across. We just put in there like the standing ovations list of vendors that people recommend here. There's a trails map. There's all kinds of good stuff to look at and to download and have at hand. And we keep adding to that. That's the kind of stuff that's in that folder, plus information on group events and other neighborhood tips that we send out to our community email list. And that is email different from what Dawn does, the official HOA business emails, the e-blasts that come from the portal. It's one that you opt into. We don't send these emails to anybody but the people who want to receive them, who just want more information about what's going on in the community. If you want to get into that, you need to email me. Check out the newsletter. It's got all this information there and how to connect with everybody. And the other thing we do, and when somebody's just a neighbor or has a concern or a group is doing something fun and they want a little publicity bit, we'll help with that too. Although I imagine Tarkara will be very good at that too. That's what we do. And thanks very much.
Thanks, Mo. All right. So let's see. Last but not least, Pavilion Committee, Bill, in your spooky background.
Yes, very spooky over here. Thank you. Welcome, new owners. I'm Bill Smiley, the chairman of the Pavilion Committee. We're a committee of five members. I kind of view us as having three main responsibilities. Of course, everyone knows about if you reserve the pavilion for a private event, we go over and do a post look through to make sure it's all clean and nice for the next people to come on along. But we also support owners with any of the questions they might have of the pavilion, how it functions, TV, the fireplaces, the fire pit and all that. You know, always come to us and ask. We're all well-versed in how a lot of that works. Also, people come across with some ideas for improvements for the pavilion, and we always take those and support you and let the board know what you're thinking, and so we like to do that as much as we can. Overall, I'd say, you know, the pavilion's opened up a little bit, and we are seeing, I got my notes down here, so we are seeing a lot of activity going on as far as private reservations. They've gone quite smoothly. I would say the community room, we're having club members and such like that are going on in there, but not a lot of other activity, which is, I understand, because we're still under somewhat of a restrictions, and so that's to be expected. However, the patios on both sides, a lot of activities going on out there, a lot of people going over, turning on the fireplace and chatting, just getting together, which is really nice to see and hear. I'd say the gym has seen a steady flow of people. If you are new, I should invite any of the new homeowners to come on over, check out the pavilion, check out the gym. We got some pretty nice equipment there. And by all means, there's a computer login you can do over there. Like, you track of all your workouts. See Don, she'll get you set up there for that. Even though we are seeing more activity over at the gym as well, or there's no conflicts as far as usage of the equipment, and bottlenecks, no issue there at all. So get on over there, get on a treadmill, bike, what have you. You should have no problems getting on. I would say be sure when you're all done with the equipment that you go ahead and wipe it down. There are some disposable disinfectant cloths there in the gym. Do that. Also, Mel mentioned the handbook. There is a little bifold information pamphlet in the entryway. A lot of it's the same stuff you'll see in the handbook, but if you like to have a hard copy, take it on home, keep it by your, you know, TV, telephone, whatever. And a lot of the information on the pavilion, how to do things, what's all in there is included in that. So by all means, go on over, check it out, and pick up a pamphlet. Don's been really good as far as keeping up on contracts for servicing the pavilion. So like the gutters were just cleaned today, but the heating, air conditioning, the plumbing, all that, we have contracts. There's also a contract for ice and snow removal. And with winter coming, that becomes an issue. Sometimes that service gets delayed. If that happens, there is a pail of ice melt in the shed. Any owner can come by and go ahead and spread that ice melt down. That'll at least protect us until the service is able to get in. I live right next door to the pavilion, and usually I'm out there having fun putting the ice melt down. So, but if I'm not around and you see an icy spot, go ahead, put it on down. That'll save some possible falls. One idea was checking on a glass recycling. Seems like we have quite a few wine bottles over there at the pavilion. So this way we can recycle those in a responsible way too. And I would say that the committee on a whole is looking forward to working with Takara as far as the calendar of events and how we can make things smoother for you and make their lives easier as well. So we'll be doing that upcoming. One thing with the pavilion, remember, we are under a mask and social distancing, so remember to adhere to that whenever you're inside the pavilion. For now, hopefully, with the numbers looking, maybe we can get beyond that, which would be really nice. Other than that, I'm on the chairman for a couple more weeks. Jeannie Reader is going to take over my position. And I have to talk to Ed. The fact that I'm leaving, I'm going to be going on to the auxiliary, which is a non-voting position on the committee, just to help with the transition and help out owners and such, but not heavy into the pavilion committee. So we are looking for another member, and hopefully we can get one of the new homeowners to come on board. By the time you get done, you'd be an expert on the pavilion, how everything works and where all the keys and locks and all that stuff is. So by all means, it's a good committee to be on, kind of fun. We have a good time and enjoy seeing other owners and trading stories. I think that's it for me. I'm going to be going on helping the block captains with their communications. And so you'll still see me running around with the radio. And of course, I'm be running around the pavilion as well. So that's it for me.
All right, great. Thank you. Mm-hmm. All right. So that takes us on to the annual calendar and vendor update. So that would be Dawn and Christina.
Yeah, I'm just scrolling down. Bear with me. So as Bill mentioned, the pavilion cleaning service, inside cleaning as of July 18th, is now 3 days a week, Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday, and the patio is cleaned once a week. The pavilion windows have a quarterly contract and they were cleaned in September. The Oak Tree Pavilion handyman installed a ramp for the pavilion trash can so it's easier to pull out of that little closet. That was done on 9/13. And then as Bill mentioned, the handyman performed the pavilion gutter cleaning today at 9. The HOA landscaper. So Monarch will post updates weekly on the portal under announcements. And so I ask homeowners to please check these for weekly updates. If you have any questions or concerns or have a work order, of course, please reach out to me and I'll take care of that for you. Also, a reminder to homeowners not to call Monarch or disturb workers directly. Report work orders directly to management or via a resident request on the portal. The updated annual 2021 annual calendar is on the portal under documents. Look for the 2022 annual calendar in December when I'll be posting it. And then just for your knowledge, there are many YouTube tutorials that have been completed on the Oak Tree YouTube page. I took advantage of the COVID closure and made a bunch of those, and they're really helpful. These can be found on the portal under links. And then as a reminder, the Oak Tree 2022 budget is now in process. And a reminder that the HOA responsibilities versus non-responsibilities is posted on the Oak Tree portal under documents, annual disclosures. A reminder that HOA portfolio management is not the same as warranty or apartment management. Management does not make decisions. Portal update, there are 230 registered members on file on the portal. And then for reports, the ACC notes, work order, violation, and association reports were included for the board. And that's it.
All right.
Let's scroll back up to the agenda.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay. So not really much to say, but we did have an update to the front yard policy that was communicated to our ownership. And that just has to do with we're having issues of management of specific plants and whatnot. So the board reviewed all of our information and we did come up with a new policy change. So we are instituting the use of pots. So everything is above ground. That way our irrigation system and whatnot is not also impacted. We were definitely having some issues with our landscaping vendor, and we are not, Steve actually said it very eloquently at one point in a meeting, but I'll paraphrase, but we're not really in a position to lose our landscaper. They're pretty impactful, and we just don't want to be wearing them down as well. So this was a kind of a long-term benefit change in policy. So if you have any questions about that, please do not hesitate to reach out to Dawn, and we can address those individually. But yeah, that was announced since our last meeting. And then I'm actually going to let Don Wilson speak to his group with the traffic calming. So he has a report on that. There you are at the beach.
So, okay, we had some of the concerns of vehicle speed on Oakwood Street. And so we reached out to Thurston County to complete a couple of speed studies. Which would provide data of the vehicle speeds traveling in that area. Two separate speed studies were recently conducted. Both studies recorded both inbound and outbound traffic speed on Oakwood Street for 2 7-day periods during this past summer. The July study found that the average speed of the traffic near the entrance to the community was approximately 29.3 miles per hour. The speed study was conducted with a total of 770 cars in and out of the facility. In August, a tracker was placed much further into the community on Oakwood Street, where the average recorded speed was just about the same, but approximately 30.3 miles per hour. And the number of vehicles recorded during this speed study were approximately 550. Additional information also indicated 91% of the vehicle traffic recorded averaged out to be traveling between 26 and 36 miles an hour, with isolated cases traveling up to 40 miles per hour. The data received from these two speed studies shows that the majority of the drivers tend to travel above the posted speed limit of 25 miles an hour. The HOA board, we've asked them to of directors to continue to remind construction vehicles and vendors to be mindful of the speed limit when coming to their changing job site locations. And we're also asking the residents to be kindly reminded to do the same and be keep the speed within the speed limit of 25 miles an hour. Information was provided to us that and some thought that a good thing to do would be to install other traffic calming measures such as speed bumps or raised crosswalks. However, Thurston County has made it very clear that they do not have the budget to fund such projects, so the cost for those projects would require funding by the Homeowners Association. Just to give you an example, if it came to the point where speed bumps were needed to be installed, it would cost the association up to $45,000. These speed bumps would have to be based on this cost, they would say five speed bumps on Oakwood Street, which would be dictated by the Thurston County. If speed bumps, installation of these barriers would also negatively impact the cost by reducing the EMS fire response times, damaging private vehicles with low ground clearance, and risk drivers damage to vendors or home delivery or the RVs are coming in and out of the community. Raised crosswalks were also looked at. These are also awfully expensive, approximately $5,000, but they could also pose a trip and fall risk to pedestrians with limited mobility. The combined data from the speed studies clearly show that drivers traveling along Oakwood Street need to slow down and follow the speed limit. If those drivers can collectively do that, the 91% of them, then we would avoid the HOA incurring expense or special assessment for these permanent physical speed barriers, such as speed bumps and raised asphalt crosswalks. In closing, I would just offer to you that as a community working together, we can significantly enhance our local traffic safety by being vigilant of pedestrians and voluntarily adhering to the posted speed limit of 25 miles an hour. That concludes my report.
All right, thanks, Don. Okay, so that takes us to our 2022 budget. The board is actively working with the NOVA management team on working through all facets of the budget. So we will be approving that here soon. And then what happens is every owner, all the membership will get a formal mailer of the budget. So you'll have an opportunity to review it and send in questions prior to our budget ratification meeting, which is scheduled for November 17th, which is a Wednesday as well. So keep that in mind. That should be coming out in the mail soon. But yeah, we're working on that. We're kind of some in review process of that. And then I didn't want to forget this because we did have someone reach out to us and gave us an idea that the board is going to be probably, once we get past the budget ratification and whatnot, revisiting, kind of considering loosening and or extending our RV load and load out policy to tailor it to maybe a little bit more of the demographic of Oaktree. So some homeowner actually did reach out and gave us some really good feedback and even some potential wording, which was really great. And we appreciated that. So that didn't get on here on the agenda. So I just wanted to make sure I didn't forget.
Jennifer, that was Doug Axtell, and I agree. The way he wrote that policy was fantastic.
Yeah, we appreciated that. So that makes it easier for us, and we do appreciate that feedback. And then we have instituted a code of conduct agreement for all of our committee members as well as our board members, and we've all signed a code of conduct. That is something new that we've recently done. It says down here in the reminders, respectful interactions. The HOA has a no tolerance policy. It's a little painful for me to have to do this, especially when I see very familiar faces frequently on our board meeting calls. But we just want to remind everyone, for those of you that might be watching this at a later date, please speak to our staff or any of our committee members or any vendors associated with the HOA respectfully. It's okay to have emotion. It's okay to have frustration. But we can't be verbally abusing anyone that works on behalf of the HOA. We want to avoid when you're coming to speak to someone at the pavilion, you're not spitting words. I mean, and I'm saying this because these are actual incidences. And refrain from language like "you're useless" because you don't like an answer. So I'm just being very transparent with you. No one deserves to be spoken to that way. So please remember that we all should be respectful in our interactions with your neighbors, with yourself. we all have bad self-talk, and with anyone that's associated working with the HOA. So there's that. Let me see if I have little notes here.
Jennifer, back on the budget, I just wanted to have the chance to remind all of the 34 participants here, or make them aware that I personally have been lobbying the other board members and getting the help of NOVA management with the idea of possibly needing to raise HOA dues. So I don't want the budget meeting to come around next month and you to be unaware that your sole homeowner board member is taking this up when he looks at the budget. I don't know if it's going to happen, but it's something we're looking at. I know that everybody has seen the amount of the cost of living going up. When you go to the stores or you're online, prices are up. Energy prices are up 25% year over year. Fuel's up 49% since last year. And if we look at cumulative rate of inflation since the first home was built here, it's gone up 12%. So that's saying that it takes $224 today's dollars to have the buying power of $200 from 4 years ago. So I want people to be aware that I'm interested in this and I'm lobbying about this. And we're going to have a discussion, the board and NOVA management, before the board meeting on the budget later this week. And if people have opinions on that, we can put it in the chat room today, or you can certainly contact the board with your opinions on it through the portal. But mainly what I'm lobbying for is keeping up with the rate of inflation. Okay?
Yeah, thanks, Steve.
Yep.
Well, we have something really exciting. Those of you may have already met Takara. Takara is our new lifestyle manager. We're really excited. I know that she's been meeting with some of the groups and the committee members and getting lots of really great ideas and feedback from owners, really kind of seeing how we can really maximize this active lifestyle that we're hoping to start incorporating and get going. So when we hit the ground running, when the villages deliver. So I'm gonna let Takara, I know she's on here, I'm gonna let her introduce herself and say hi.
Well, hello, my name is Takara. So I have met a handful of you guys already. For those of you that I have not met yet, I look forward to meeting you in the very near future. Currently, I am in the pavilion every Thursday with Dawn between 8 a.m. and about 4 p.m. So if you have anything that you want to come down and talk to me about, or any ideas that you have, any events or activities that you're involved in that you would like a support system, I'm more than happy to have those meetings with you. My goal is to live in a fantasy world where in 2022, COVID is not really as stringent as it has been in these past years. So I really want to focus on the opportunity to build social events for all of us, to all of the community members, to participate in and to enjoy, and just an opportunity to create that whole active lifestyle like Jennifer was talking about. So not just social gatherings, but also fitness programs, social gatherings outside of the community, relationships with local business partners. So that's my focus as of right now. I want to reiterate to everybody that I am coming in as an asset to the community. In no way, shape, or form do I plan on changing anything that you guys are passionate about or that you guys enjoy currently. But if you see places for improvement, I am absolutely all here and all ears to hear those recommendations. And hopefully we can work together to create the best possible lifestyle for our Ovation Nation.
Awesome. Thanks, Takara. I'm very excited and really appreciate everything you've done so far, and looking forward to all the cool things that we're going to get to do here in the community. So yeah, thanks for joining us.
Thank you, everyone. And just one last thing, if you have time tomorrow to pop in and introduce yourself, if I have not already met you, please, by all means, do so. I would love to get the face to name ratios taken care of early on.
Great. Thanks. All right. So, Dawn, did you have the reminder for the colder temps?
Yes, just a reminder, as we start seeing some crazy stormy weather, we're unfortunately going to have ice, maybe even snow. So last year, we did come up with a policy that when snow starts to fall, that the committee committees would meet with the chairs and have a discussion with the board about if you think that it's time to bring the snowplow out. We do have a contract with a snowplow, but as a reminder, he can only do a little bit of the entry and the parking lots and the alleyways, because Thurston County is so stringent on not plowing their roads. So that's a little inconvenient for us, but we're doing the best that we can. We also have Monarch, who is spreading ice melt. They do the mailboxes, they do the pavilion area, and we have added, and thank you, Kathy Varney, if you're on this call today, her suggestion was brilliant to add the sidewalk that goes from the pavilion over to the first set of mailboxes. And so we did talk with Monarch and asked them if they would please add that for safety purposes, and they will be adding that. And so as Bill mentioned, from the pavilion, we do have ice melt that I keep stocked in that little garbage closet by the pavilion. And so we all kind of do our part together as a team to keep ice melt down. And so I encourage homeowners, if you see a spot that we missed or that suddenly became icy, feel free to go in and grab some of that ice melt. We also have cones that we used last year during our big snow. I do my best whenever I hear, well, we know how the weather is in Washington, but when I hear that we're going to get snow, I do my best to send an e-blast out to get everybody just kind of prepared and work closely with the pavilion committee and with the landscape committee to make sure that we have a plan of action. So I just want you to know that we definitely have a plan and we are working towards that as we start to experience colder temperatures.
And just to reiterate and clarify for what Don was saying, the main thoroughfare roads like Arrowroot, Oakwood, those are public roads owned and maintained by Thurston County. And the association owns our alley loads, parking lots, anything of that nature. So just for clarification on that, that's why we can't do the main roads, because those are all owned and maintained by Thurston County. So just to clarify that in case anyone's questioning. Steve, did you have something? I saw you unmuted.
Just preparing for the next portion.
Oh, okay. So the Taylor Morrison portion, are you going to do that?
Well, the part about a certain letter we received, the respectful interactions is on the agenda.
Yep, yeah. Go ahead and I will let you go there.
So good. Thanks, Jennifer. So as Jennifer was saying earlier, recently with the help of the HOA committee chairs, the board of directors drafted a written code of conduct to help guide residents who volunteer their time, and we appreciate that, those that serve on the committees, but also to hold those accountable that choose to converse or behave in an unprofessional or disrespectful manner toward others. All committee members starting or continuing their terms this month have been presented with this document for signature. And as Jennifer was saying as well, in that same spirit, it is especially important that all residents respectfully interact with HOA managers, our employees, HOA contracted service providers and landscape workers, and residents giving of their personal time to serve on committees or on research groups. Now I'm going to talk about a letter we recently received, and I realized that most likely the 34 participants that joined in this meeting, I don't want you to take this personally, and you're probably not part of the group that signed this, the owners of Ovation anonymously, but it's important that we're all aware that this occurs, and I would request your help in trying to stop these types of things from happening. So just yesterday, Nova Management received an anonymous complaint letter mysteriously signed, the homeowners of Ovation. And in this letter, largely complained that the board and the manager are too lax when enforcing community rules and accused management of favoritism. But after complaining that we're too lax, it would then flip-flop and advised us of the need to be flexible as well. I want to bring this to the attention of the membership and the participants here at this meeting, because anonymous letters are really an ineffective form of communication if you're seeking to affect change or seek a resolution to a grievance. If we, the board and management, cannot contact you to hear you out and engage in constructive, respectful, and civil conversation, then we have no choice but to ignore your suggestions in an anonymous letter. But believe me, we do not want to prohibit your constructive input. We welcome it. Our community is still forming, And although we will experience growing pains now and again, and we already have, it is still essential that we come together in helping to decide what kind of community you and us envision for full build-out. We have choices in making this community become what we'd like it to see, what we envision. I said this before, and please remember that a Facebook page or a social media site is not an acceptable way to communicate with your HOA management or the board. Please use the homeowners portal, visit the HOA manager during on-site office hours, or contact the committee responsible for your subject. The committees do great work. I can assure every resident that both the HOA manager as well as the event coordinator have the full support of each of your board members, including me, and NOVA Management Headquarters as well. I also want you to know just how impressed I've been with our HOA manager and my fellow board members. That group and myself, we are in communication with each other on a daily basis by email and phone, and we meet either in person or face-to-face electronically on a weekly basis. All of them, including NOVA Management Headquarters, involve me in each decision they make, and they lean on me to draft resident responses and policies. They invite me to share the pulse of our community with them as well. I feel very included and very involved. So that's it, folks. Let's be respectful in our interactions. Thank you.
Thanks, Steve. Very well put. All right, so looks like our next thing is the blank Taylor Morrison section. And good news, I get to talk about the villages today a little bit. Don't get too excited because I don't have specifics, but I wanna kind of go over some of the type of programming and sort of the opportunities for Takara to also expand on and create events and activities for our community. So this could be slightly subject to change, but for right now, this is what we're definitely planning on. We're in the permit process for the buildings, and there's going to be two main buildings for the villages. The first building is going to essentially be sort of the great room slash banquet room, and that one actually is right now projected to open and deliver in the spring and summer of 2023. And then the second building, which is going to be mainly the fitness building and the pool, that type of building, that one is actually projected a little farther out, sort of winter 23, spring 2024, barring that we don't have any weird, like you have had some supply chain issues with your own personal projects. So let's talk about what might be going on in some of these buildings. So, okay, looks like we're going to have a pet dog area that's going to be fenced in with some covered seating. We're going to have a large event lawn, so that'll be great to do tented events in the summer and all sorts of other activities, maybe like a movie in the park kind of thing. We'll have bocce ball courts. We will have some pickleball slash general sport courts. That great room, that banquet room, is going to have a demo kitchen and a fireplace as well. They'll be attached to each building. There'll be covered outdoor patio areas with seating and some, one will definitely have an uncovered fire pit, kind of like what we have at the pavilion, and one will have a covered fire pit. The inside, kind of the same building with the demo kitchen, there'll be a sort of a general sitting area for clubs with some tables for games for clubs to meet at and just some open space there. The other building with the pool will have a fitness area slash movement studio. The outdoor patio will also be available for fitness activities as weather permits. Let's see. And then obviously the pool, it is a lap pool with an outdoor spa slash hot tub. Wasn't able to pull the full dimensions, so I cannot confirm if it's in a junior Olympic lap pool, but what I have been told that it's larger than Tahale's, which Karen and I actually went and visited a while back and it was pretty large. So I think this might be just slightly shy of an Olympic junior lap pool, but quite big enough for activities and for swimming. So that's pretty much what we're kind of planning right now. I don't have specifics. I know someone wrote in some questions about how many fitness pieces of fitness equipment, what type. We haven't really gotten to the furnishing program aspect of the villages yet. I am working on getting us a visual rendering of what this will all look like as well. I know that they're still working through that process right now with the permit process. So more to come, and I know that we want to share it with you, just want to make sure that we have the right information to share with you. So we're very excited to have Takara on board to help implement and be part of that kind of programming process. And so we're very excited. So I see some questions popping up. Let's see. So someone asked, this is a question to Steve, what will be your approach to seek community member input?
So Mary, what are you referring to there?
Oh, she's muted.
Let me unmute. Okay, thank you. Well, actually, just in general, you were elected a few months ago, and I haven't, if there's been an outreach by you to members of the community to generally talk about items that might be of interest in the community or perhaps issues that the board is dealing with that could be of, have community member input into your thinking as our homeowner on the board. Forgive me if I've missed an outreach, but that's really what I'm asking about.
Right. So I always have to be careful about receiving information without the presence of the other board members. So if you could use the portal if you have a question. If we talk about something as an example, like Doug Axtell's suggestion for extending the RV parking policy, because we're a little older and it takes us a little longer than 24 hours sometimes to do physical labor. Right, Doug? He's nodding his head. He's muted. And he gave some great input and provided a policy. He sort of presented a problem and gave a solution at the same time, made it very easy for us to consider. Other than that, what you're doing right now is a way to provide your input. Did you have something else you're interested in?
No, I'm not asking about anything specific to this meeting or this agenda. In general, as you're working with the board, I understand that you don't want to, you can't as an individual speak for the board, but as an individual board member and the only elected homeowner, what you're saying is writing to you via the portal is the way that we should communicate with you. How do you find out about things that are prospective that we know nothing about? How do you sense, or you try to sense where the homeowners might, what their opinions might be on something that the board is thinking about and has not yet brought forward in an agenda?
So using the HOA manager to bring up your suggestions is the way to get it to the three board members at once. And I do try to make it a point to, excuse me if my cat jumps into the screen here, go to all the social events that are scheduled at the pavilion and elsewhere, and you can always bend my ear in a social environment about your suggestions as well.
Well, I appreciate that, but I think we're all trying not to abuse the volunteer, you know, community members by bending their ear when we catch them on the street. So I'll use the portal, I guess.
Yeah. Mary, you can always reach out to me. You can do a resident request. The example that Steve brought up was brilliant. That is, Doug Extell wrote to me and had a suggestion that he asked that I forward on to the board, his dilemma kind of, and then his solution, which was perfect. And so I forwarded it to the board. They discussed, and we'll be reviewing that in 2022 when the RV parking is kind of more an issue less than it is right now, where nobody's really using the RVs.
And Mary, let me put a bow on that. I agree, it's probably not the best idea to bend a committee member's ear or my own walking about. But when we go to a social setting, like the upcoming Halloween social, or just previously the introduction with Takara, we know our positions and we know we're in a social setting, and we fully expect to be engaged and to answer questions and be in conversation about what's going on in our positions. So that's different in my opinion.
If I could, I'd like to speak to that also. Thank you, Mary. We like to protect the quiet enjoyment of their home and community for our homeowner board member and our committee members. So I think it still works best to bring any concern you may have to Dawn, to the board. And let me just smile as I say how much the board loves having Steve there. We can say, hey, Steve, this has been brought up. What's up? And he will go on that like our missile. He goes out in the community and will seek answers or responses from homeowners. So again, if something's concerning, please bring it to Dawn, bring it, or just a suggestion. I don't want to say it's always concerning, but whatever you're thinking, send it to Dawn. She'll send it to all of the board members, and then we'll assign Steve to go do it.
Okay, other questions? Let's use that chat function. Everybody know where it is?
At the bottom.
Yep.
You might have to scroll your pointer on it to highlight it. And I think I'm going to kind of piggyback, not to just, you know, beat it down, but Mary brings up a really good point too. I think people don't reach out and ask a question. And so if you hear like, I don't know, something churning in the community, a rumor or just a statement, and you want clarification, please don't be afraid to reach out to Dawn to have it clarified by either her or the board or all of us, whomever. We're more than happy to do that because sometimes things get to us after they've been churned around a little bit and it kind of gets a little bit off the main point in the topic and it becomes something else that it didn't need to be. So we're always available for that and we don't mind doing that. You may not always like the answer, I can't guarantee that, but we would prefer that you asked if you heard something that seemed a little off or disconcerting or just weird, whatever the insert adjective, please don't be afraid to reach out. And that's another way to kind of, you as a homeowner can help the board guide on input or a pulse of the community that Steve or someone else may not be aware of. So that's another way to keep us connected.
One new message.
Oh, what's that, Bill?
Ooh, Bill said the reminder for the shakeout tomorrow.
Do you want to remind people what the shakeout is for those that may not be aware?
Bill, where are you? Or does Mike want to do
it? I don't know. I mean, just talk about it. No, we have, a statewide shakeout thing, earthquake disaster thing. So you might have heard from your block captains or what have you. What's going on tomorrow? I think it's like 1:20. I was actually kind of hoping someone out there would remind people of it, but there is the shakeout tomorrow. So just be aware that there's going to be activities going on. Talk to your block captains to find out what you're supposed to do. And we'll see how it goes.
Mike,
That's all.
It starts at 10:21.
Oh, thank you, Bob.
It's a national thing. It's on the third Thursday of every year in October, third Thursday in October every year. And the day that falls on becomes the time in the morning that it starts. So last year it was on 10:15 and it started at 10:15. So this year, the third Thursday is the 21st and it will start at 10:21.
Good to know.
So you'll always know that. We've added just a little bit to it this year where we're asking homeowners to attend a spot that has been designated within the borders of their particular block to come in and check in with one of the block captains, at which point we will thank them and they may return home. That's a little more than we did last year. And the point is merely just to emphasize that this was a good day to stop and think about making preparations and understanding what the risks would be and acting on them. And so it will be a very simple, short process. And we're looking forward to everybody's involvement and we thank you in advance.
Great, thank you, Mike. Well, just a reminder for those of you who have not met Takara or would like to, you know, engage with her a little bit more about maybe some suggestions or just, you know, clubs, etc., that of that nature. She's going to be in the pavilion tomorrow from 8 to 4. Dom will be there as well if you have HOA related questions. And just to reiterate and define, Takara does nothing HOA related. So she does pay assessments, she doesn't do work orders. She's all about the fun. So just keep that in mind. So if you have an issue with a shrub or whatnot, that still goes to Dawn. Nothing's changed in that department. But if you're wondering how to get more involved and active, that's all Takara. Just trying to see if anyone chats. This is where I feel like we need Jeopardy music.
I know.
It's Craig Gable.
Hi, Craig.
I just want to bring to everybody's attention, kind of as a civic duty kind of thing, and particularly, Mel, this is something that you might want to note for communications purposes, but there's going to be a community shred event here in Lacey.
Ooh.
On Saturday, November 6th, from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., at the LeMay Mobile Shredding Facility, which is at 2910 Hogum Bay Road. So it's on the other side of I-5 and just off of Marvin Road. So bring that to people's attention. It's a drive-through shredding event, maximum of 3 shred boxes per vehicle.
Oh, okay. Thanks.
Just thought people might like to know that.
That's great.
Maybe at some point in time we can actually engage LeMay and have them come into our own community as we get bigger and bigger and do one on site.
Yeah, great suggestion, Craig.
For sure. Well, if we don't have any questions right now, like we said before, feel free to reach out to Dawn. You know, sometimes we get those napkin thoughts later on in the day and you're like, oh, I should have asked about that. So,
or just before bed.
Yeah, or
that's so, always me.
Karen and I joke about our shower thoughts in the morning of that day. We're like, oh, I thought about this in the shower. I had a great idea in the shower. So it's random times in life when you have those thoughts. So please feel free to share them with Dawn. She'll get them to the whole board. But if we don't have anything else, I guess we can formally adjourn the meeting at 5:04. All right, there we have it. Another one in the books. And we'll see you in about a month for the budget ratification meeting and look forward to your mailer.
Yes, thank you all. It's great seeing you. Thank you, board and committees.
No, you
appreciate you all. Thank you.